Operations at LRT2 stations were disrupted due to a fire incident. Let's now get an update from our correspondent Karen De Guzman. Karen, go ahead.
Good morning, Mike. After the clearing and safety assessment conducted by the Light Rail Transit Authority, LRT2 resumes its full operations today. The LRTA implemented limited operations yesterday due to a fire incident at a residential area adjacent to the Recta station. The fire that broke out in Barangay 310, Santa Cruz, Manila, affected the LRT2 power supply and signaling systems at the said station. LRT2 lines are now all operational from Recta station to Antipolo station and vice versa. Meanwhile, Mike, as you can see behind my back, this is the elevated connecting bridge which serves as a link or transfer of passengers from LRT2 Recta station to LRT1 Doroteo Jose station that is also damaged and is currently impassable to the passengers. The management said they will be rehabilitating this area before opening this back to the public. The LRTA advised passengers to use the other road while they are still fixing the said bridge. Also, Mike, the entrance of the north entrance here at the Recta station is also closed because some of the evacuees have no choice but to stay on the streets since the evacuation area at the basketball court are already full. Mike?
All right. So, Karen, just to be clear, the fire didn't actually affect the station itself, but the neighboring residents, right? But somehow the power system was affected. Is that correct, Karen?
Yes, that's right, Mike. The residential area is just adjacent here at the Recta station, and parts of the said bridge was the only one that is damaged. So after conducting the safety assessment of the LRTA, the LRT2 line is now full back on its operations.
Mm-hmm. Do we know, do you have any idea, Karen, what caused the fire?
As of the latest update, the Bureau of Fire Protection is still investigating as to the cause of the fire.
Mm-hmm. And Karen, I understand that this area is used by thousands of commuters every day who transfer from one train station to another. Did the LRT give any timetable how soon they can rehabilitate this particular area?
We are still waiting for the final statement of LRT regarding to that. Because as I've said earlier, the north entrance here at the Recta station is currently closed since around 2,000 evacuees have stayed here outside on the Recta station.
Mm-hmm.
So we are still waiting for the data from the LRTA.
Mm-hmm. No information as well on long-term plans of the LRT with respect to this area, because if you have if you've been to that area, you can really see that it's surrounded by residents. So you can reasonably expect this situation to happen again. No word so far from LRTA?
There's still no statement from LRTA, but I will be asking that question and I will return to you, Mike.
All right. Thank you so much for that update, Karen De Guzman.
A farmers' group warned supply of white onions in the Philippines may last only until July this year. Now, the group SINAG urges the Philippine government to import white onions by July. This is to avert a possible shortage and price increase. But the group said supplies of red onions are sufficient until the end of the year. At present, prices of red and white onions range from 150 to 200 pesos per kilo, slightly higher than last month's 100 peso average. The Agriculture Department earlier said they are considering onion importation, but only during the lean season.
Expect natin by siguro July, palabas na lahat na puting sibuyas. Kaya ang inaano natin na dapat magpasok na ng July yung puting sibuyas. Dapat i-meet na yung mga cold storage owner tsaka yung inventory ng mga magsasaka para makita yung ilan pa ang nasa ground.
The Philippines' Cybersecurity Investigation and Coordinating Center said to go after social media influencers who promote online gambling on their respective platforms. This after it was found most users have fallen victim to the alleged phishing scheme that hit eWallet GCash last week were those who use gambling apps. On Friday, GCash officials faced the CICC to respond to the recent unauthorized withdrawal of funds that affected some users.
Common na app na nandito sa mga taong na-scam na to, yung gambling app. Kasi ito, pag nag-login ka sa kanya, ang hihingi niya sa iyo MPIN mo. Para pag ikaw, nagdagdag ka o nagtawag nila, recharge ka ng pera doon sa wallet, sa ano mo, sa game mo, diretso na yun sa GCash.
Next natin na titirahin dito will be the influencers eh. Because apparently, eh, alam mo, mga milyon, dan libo yung mga kanilang mga followers. Dapat take down din yung kanilang mga ano promotion on gambling.
On to Kuwait's entry ban on Filipinos. Some 3,000 Filipinos have already been affected by Kuwait's new policy. It was imposed due to the Philippine government's alleged non-compliance of a labor agreement with Kuwait, a claim denied by Filipino officials. Now, the Philippine Migrant Workers Department says the issue may have stemmed from the government's creation of shelters for abused Filipino workers in Kuwait.
Allegedly, na meron tayong pagkukulang sa agreement na yan, eh, medyo false kasi hindi naman tayo nag-agree that we will not establish a shelter. Sa 2018 agreement natin na pinirmahan ng Pilipinas at ng Kuwait, eh nandun sa provisions natin na the embassy will be operating a shelter para sa mga kababayan natin.
Some Philippine officials are expected to fly to Kuwait to address the concern. Government also vows assistance for affected Filipinos.
At ang DMW magtutungo sa Kuwait kasi kailangan natin din klaruhin ano yung rationale, ano yung dahilan, ano yung mga issues na bumabalot dito sa suspension at para malaman din natin kung ano ang mga posibleng solusyon.
Another encounter between Philippine and Chinese vessels in the West Philippine Sea, the Philippine Coast Guard confirms receiving a radio call challenge from the Chinese Navy. It happened when the PCG was on its way to Pagasa Island to distribute aid to residents.
Normal naman po yan kasi if you try to look at market features ng Philippines, Vietnam, China, halos pagkadikit-dikit lang kasi siya eh. So lalo pag kumapit ka ng aeroplano, may possibility mag-ano mo yung sinasabi nilang territorial airspace nila. We responded to voice radio and telling them this is a normal routine.
PCG has been strengthening its defenses in the West Philippine Sea. It also recently placed buoys in some parts of the disputed waters.
Anilagay po namin yung cardinal markers sa areas ng Batan, Balagtas Reef, Panata, Bota, and Bulan Pilipe. Cardinal Park's visibility is a warning, an alarm for the seafarers or users at sea. That direction giving alarm na medyo hindi maganda for navigation, no? That may mapahuran.